is that which prevents us as fiscal and eventual, and particularly with IDS and IPSCs. That's how you, because as my colleague said the other time, it's not just only blocking them, you have to know what they're doing, who is attacking you. So with an IDS and IPS prefer to be configured in network without much human intervention. So anytime there's a scan, a particular type of scan or particular type of connection, the IPS will be configured in network, sever the connection, and establish another one-hot connection. So it's particularly with IPSs and IDSs. It's not the popular open source IDS. It's not the open source. Though I think now it's owned by Cisco, but it's still maintaining the open source. Let's go to open source as well, but it is owned by Rapid7. They just still maintain Metasploit as an open source framework. Or actually it's owned by Rapid7. So this now we are using Windows, this is a Windows exploit, and this is the name of that vulnerability I'm talking about. MS04011, the other code. So now those are what we're using that particular exploit. So let's go on. So now we're going to set the remote host on the target computer as a so I've set the remote host, this is our target computer. Remote host, one that is the IP address of the XP system. And now I want to set the payload. The payload is how am I going to communicate with that exploited system, with the host, with the target system, once I'm not exploited. So the way I'm going to communicate is like this. There are so many ways. So now I'm going to use VNC inject, which is part of the Metasploit framework that you can use to execute remote code on the target system. And I'm going to use reverse TCP. Reverse TCP means that once I've exploited the system, I'm going to command that system to send in packets to me. So I have a port open on my own local system. The system is going to be talking to me, and me, I'm going to be the communication with the system. The aim of that is that will now prevent firewall from blocking our communication. Because most firewalls block incoming communications and not outgoing communications. So in that case, since I'm most of the communications coming from the target system to my own system, that means that the firewall will not allow communication to crash. Everybody okay with that? Just a way of bypassing the firewall. So now I'm going to set the local host. So I've set the local home, so it's my own computer now, the IP address. Then I'm going to set the local home. And that's the port on which we're going to communicate. I'm just setting it to port 821. In order to avoid the well-known ports, like your port 80, for it to be FTP ports, telnet port, and also a port. To avoid that, I'm just setting the port 821. So now the home part is exploit. Thank you. So now we notice that my Windows 7 is going to bring up so you can notice this is my Windows 7. Think of these two systems as totally different systems. One is in Russia, one is in Nigeria. One with the XP system could be in NCC. I don't want to say the attacker is in NCC. So in such a case, if you look at it, it's not like the remote desktop thing. What I have on my XP screen, I now have on my Windows 7 screen. Now I have on my, okay, for instance, that file test, this is the Windows 7 system. That file test, the national secret file, I can now view the file from my Windows 7 system, which might be in Russia or anywhere. I can now remotely view the file. So, you know, information security is about CIA, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. So, look at how this could be an attack all three. So, now I've hacked into the system. I can do anything I want to do on this XP system. So now confidentiality. Confidentiality means that you are not authorized to view that particular file. You cannot view that particular file. Only authorized to view that particular file. But me from Russia now, I can have secret files. A quick non-functional compatibility on the XP system, on the Windows 7 system. When it comes to integrity, integrity means that if you are not authorized to modify the file, to make change to the file, you should not be able to make change to the file. Whereby, just remove those dots. Come back to the XP system, the dots at one. That's an attack on integrity. Remotely now. Then if I also need them to, I could even see if you don't ask me to see James. Just say no. I could even come here. You notice the cursor is waving a bit because it's a remote execution from the remote cursor. So I could even come here, right click, and delete this file. I actually want to national secrets have been taken about. This is an attack on our community. So from remotely now, I cannot hack into any XP system that has not been patched. Remember, if you're doing this lab at home, don't patch. Like when you're installing the XP on your VMware, don't update. Don't patch more than service pack 1, but if service pack 2, this particular XP pack will not work. So this is then how to hack into an XP system that hasn't been patched. I have to do whatever I want to do. System. Any questions, please?
What happens if you close all the ports?
If you close
all the ports, an administrator now.
Close all the ports. That's like, it's almost like saying what purpose is a computer that doesn't have, that doesn't connect to the internet, no USB, no CD drive. No information comes in. So, and computers process information. So if no information is coming in, close every single port, it can't do any business. It can't be any, it's like a dot computer, there's no point in having such a computer. You close port 80, FTP, normally FTP is not closed. And you open it as a security person, FTP should always have closed, for example, secure.com. When you close port 80, for instance, no web traffic. Close your mail ports, SMTP, we always port, no email traffic. And you also have, for most of your applications, when you store software, they use all those inter-end ports, 10,000 above ports, they just dynamically choose ports, and they run the application to your system. Look at it. They close all the ports. Those applications must be ports to run your system. Databases use ports, even though you're using them locally. Database, all applications use selected ports, use selected functions. So it's a risk assessment. That is like, talk about risk avoidance. Avoiding risk. And risk avoidance is never a good risk treatment advice. It's like saying that I'm not going to, a businessman that sells flowers says I'm not going to go online, I'm not going to sell flowers online because there are hackers online. It's like you're running away. So instead, you should, instead, you can get somebody that can do the secure site and they will not sell flowers online. So risk avoidance. There's some material, there's some security certification. Where risk avoidance is not taken as a risk treatment on the sector. Risk treatment is the best. So, those ports. Identify those ports. tell me, identify those ports, close those ports, identify the ports that set your business function, open those ports, and close all the ports. So, that's the question.
Yes, thank you very much. What you have just perspective is that you have just shown a problem now that somebody has successfully passed through the system. So what are we to do to install that?
Okay, in this particular case, you have to, this is actually a test on patch management. Like the engineer tester comes into the environment, he doesn't know how secure the environment is and everything. So he wants to test how, and it's an XP environment, he wants to test what's the level of patches that are done. Obviously, a penetration tester will not emit that national secret file, it will not go that far. But he does write a report and show you that you have this vulnerable. So the security testing in-house will now patch the system. So instead of it to be service pack 1, we'll now patch it up to service pack 2. And once the service pack 2 is patched, that vulnerability will not work. But it's always good to always be running continuous penetration testing, because that agent has something exploit on the meta, metasploit. When you update from time to time, you can put 1,000, you can rise to 1,005. Yeah, exploits are being added all the time. There are 0-day vulnerabilities. There are 0-day vulnerabilities that people exploit. Nobody knew about that vulnerability before, and now they now know about it. So you have to always be.
Thank you.
So thank you for that
question.
Security is a journey, it's not a destination. There are always vulnerabilities, there are always risk mitigation strategies, there are always security controls, there are always put in place, and the cycle continues. Any further questions?
Okay. In the absence of no questions,
when some of us are hearing about ACAS, I would say some people might have maybe probably not even seen one physically. But today you are seeing one ACA, but who happens to be a white one, a white hat, not a black hat. A round of applause for him once again. As you have said, we as an organization, we are here to create that awareness. And in the creation of awareness, that does not mean you can really go in depth into your lapses or the vulnerabilities that NCC have actually exposed to, because we have not really come in to do a kind of vulnerability test for you. But from the outside view of it, we believe one way or the other, we are to really enhance your knowledge. We are to also expose you to some of the challenges that you might be facing, or probably that you may face in terms of carrying out your work as an IT expert. We believe after today, you need to go further to study more about this. Don't just rely on just the information that we've given. and from the management angle, I would say maybe you send the staff for certification exams, also for training, further training, or probably we have a training that is coming up on April, which my vice president will come in and to talk about. Send your staff for training, upgrade their knowledge skill, and we believe at the end we have a better cyber security environment. I'll call on the vice president to come. He's a lecturer from the Federal University of MENA to come and tell us more about the conference that is coming up by April. Welcome, sir.
We sincerely thank you for your time, and I want to come from the last presenter talking about the attacks, and also talking about the vulnerability testers. We should note that the tools these people use, they don't vary in any way. The only thing is the vulnerability testers, they are doing this with permissions, maybe from organizations, to be able to access the system in order to seek vulnerabilities for the systems, to be able to create patches in such systems. But for the attackers, they do this for personal gains. So, well, basically, whatever you want to do based on these tools, it doesn't really varies in the tools the vulnerability testers use and also the attackers used. The Cyber Security Expert Association of Nigeria is a non-profit organization, and it requires expertise in the area of information security. And I believe all of us here are, from the IT section, and it is a good thing if we can come together to want to rub minds on how we can, better improve our skills in the area of information security. And also, we have as an organization, we do so many things for members, especially he talks about the workshop. We normally have workshop 3-4 times in a year, that is trying to update members in their the profession and tell them, because the idea of cybersecurity is a thing that you have to be up to date with activities happening in the world. So we try and as much as possible to update members on this through the organization of workshops for members, which will be compulsory for members too. And also we have this conference coming up. It used to be annual thing. Like the last year we had the Cyber Secure Nigeria 2015, which was held at Nikon Hilton, and this one will be having this Cyber Secure Nigeria 2016, which will be held in NAF Conference Center. That is April 6th to 7th of this year. And we want one of you to be here, because we'll have different stakeholders coming to share rock minds on issues of information security. Not only that, the association also have the Stop Thing Connecting, in which we partner with other association across the world, because it's a global thing in which we try to campaign on how to stay safe. And the Stop Thing Connecting is an awareness campaign to enable individuals to understand the threats of the internet and how you want to make use of the internet and be safe while using the internet. And since internet is a global thing, it's everybody's business. Even you are in IT, you are not in IT, as long as you go into the net, it becomes mandatory for us to create this awareness to everybody to be conscious of what they do online. So this campaign we normally go, especially I think we had one in the FUT a launch, and we had one yesterday in University of Abuja, where we have the students and staffs, telling them, giving them some tips on how they can, be careful whatever they do online. This is some of the programs the association have for you for our members and also for the general, you know, public. And so much, you know, we'll be pleased if at least we'll have some of you on board to be able to help us, you know, and be part of, you know, the running of the organization, and also, you know, able to, like, you know, come together and, you know, compromise on, you know, issues as it regards, you know, information security. And hopefully, I think we'll get a response from that soon. Thank you.